is Nadia Mahmoudi. She has completed her PhD in physics. Her primary area of interest includes nanotechnology and nanoelectronics. She has experience in design and fabrication of nanobiosensors and thin films. Her area of expertise also includes DNA sensors and semiconductors. She attended an international conference and exposition on the invention of institution of higher learning, and she won silver medal.
Repeating sugar molecule and phosphate sugar. Each group with hard diaphragm walls is covalently bound in other in each other. You can see another DNA structure. DNA has four bases: guanine, cytosine, adenine, and thymine. The structure for guanine and cytosine base pair with three hydrogen bonding, you can see in this picture. And adenine and thymine has pair with two hydrogen bonds. For significant of DNA, because of non-escape dimension, self-assembling characteristics are extraordinary physically and chemical behavior. Self-assembling materials is that if a section of the DNA has damage or have some problem, they can repair itself. It means that in this chip, after has a problem about the one section of this chip, it can be repaired itself, and it's useful for nano-electronic device. Combination of DNA and developing new electronic device from it is so attracting for scientists, producing sensors, solar cells, biological sensors for UV batteries, and so on. From DNA will definitely improve the industry, medical care, and ordinary life. Telescope DNA is used in biology, bioelectronic, and engineering. Combination of nanotechnology, bioengineering, and biology would lead to cutting-edge technological development. DNA as a biological molecule has shown promising results in fabrication of nanostructure and nanotechnology devices. This section is to prepare the fabrication chip. Then some of them, our work is two sections. Some of them prepare the DNA, DNA extraction in biological lab in our University of New York, and after that used in electronic device. First of all, to explain about the result, is after preparation, the samples, and you can see we create nano gap on aluminum. In this image is atomic force microscopic imaging of bundle of DNA strands, illustrate the formation of nano gaps and nano patterns corresponding to the dimension of the strand using the experimental. For these methods of fabrication nano gap, there are several ways to create nano gap in an electronic device. For example, for ion beam, electron beam, nano imprint lithography, lithography with electrical force, microscope, and electron migration technique. But this technique, some of them is very expensive, some of them it's unflexible. But in our work, we achieved the cost-effective method to create nano gap and use in electronics. Some of the results you can see in this slide, the dimension of the gap, and you can see this is the nanoscale, an AFM image of etched aluminum sulfate. This is another slide of the result, is also is AFM image for bundle of DNA strand effect on aluminum. You can see the nano gap about the related to our work. This is four times to creation nano gap after 10 minutes, 20, 30, and 40 minutes. You can see after 10 minutes, the nano gap is about 27 nanometer. After 20, it will increase. Also after 30 and 40 minutes. In this diagram, you can get maximum depth versus the reaction time. After time, the nano gaps will be increased. For conclusion, a new method of fabrication, nanometer scale patterning without the need to the lithography was reported in this project. I mean, the lithography is very, as I told before, is very expensive, but this method is cost effective. The DNA strand can be very important as nano nanostructure material in nanotechnology and nanolithography system. In this work, we have utilized this structure for nanopatterning using the principle of the chemical etching mechanism. Chemical interaction between the aluminum and DNA strand causes etching of the deposit aluminum tintillants, leaving imprint of the strand of the surface. The patterning achieved using the DNA strand as shown in this work. We simply low cost and transition process. Further optimization based on the important method proposed may result in high pattern surface, which could find very variety of application in nanoelectronics and nanobioelectronics, especially in the fabrication of biosensors. This list of our publication, patent, award, and published abroad. Then I would like to express my thanks to my supervisors, Prof. Van Haliza and Dr. Bangladesh, and all of the members of the Faculty of Science, Mr. Muhammad Jalal Firuznia, Dr. Ziai, Dr. Memariani, and Dr. Kaji. And thank you for your time and attention.